Women are now taking themselves seriously, and women's interests are much more profound than how to make meatloaf 12 new ways.
I would try to write about the mayor, and they would say, no, you can write about the wife of the mayor. And perhaps the low point there was writing an entire article about textured stockings.
Gloria Steinem is editor of MS. A feminist campaigner and writer, she was one of the founders.
It started in desperation, I think, because there were just a great many women writers and editors who didn't feel that they were working on magazines that they read. It just was clear that there was no other way that we could be honest about women's experience.
We were a group of women writers sitting in my living room trying to figure out how to get out the writing that we cared about. And Florence Kennedy, a wonderful lawyer, outrageous woman, said, nobody reads newsletters. How about a magazine?
We then started to try to raise money, which turned out to be impossible. Everybody said, no, you're crazy, and magazines don't make money. And really, the only thing that enabled us to demonstrate that women really did want this kind of magazine was that New York Magazine gave us enough money to put out a test issue.
Clay Felker, the editor of New York Magazine, his first idea was that he would do an article about help at home, which he thought somehow would cure the need for a women's movement if women had help raising their children. But we explained that it was way more diverse in its goals than that.
MS began as a supplement to the successful New York Magazine and sold so well that a preview issue in its own right was put out on newsstands across the United States. In spite of gloomy predictions that most American women just wouldn't be interested, the 300,000 copies printed sold out in 8 days.
We put Wonder Woman on the cover as a colossus striding through a city, distributing food with one hand and stopping war and bombs with the other.
We are here to announce our determination to stand together in defense of a woman's right to abortion.
MS was intended to take feminism into the glossy mainstream, with articles covering everything from power to finances, body image to violence. Alice Walker wrote for it. So did Maya Angelou, Kate Millett, Doris Lessing. And so did Steinem herself, contributing some of the wit and edge that she believed essential in getting the message across.
We got stuffed mailbags of letters, which I knew from writing for other women's magazines was very unusual. Women readers seemed to feel this was a kind of personal note to them, and they responded personally.
It is difficult to express the sense of exhilaration I experienced upon finding in print the ideas which have been smoldering in my semi-rebellious soul for some 40 years. It's comforting to know that I'm not alone.
For some time, the advertisers were rather less responsive, and though matters have improved, ads are still few and far between.
The single most difficult thing was to try to get advertising, because in women's magazines, the tradition was that the advertiser came in next to an article praising the product. So there would be a shampoo ad next to hair care, and we weren't doing that.
The foundation of this magazine, and makes it different from others, is that it simply considers that women are human beings. That doesn't sound very revolutionary, but it is, because the other magazines are still arguing about it.